Let's see, what else do we got? Oh, layer groups. Let's look at some layer groups real quick. So one thing with layer groups, talked about layers a little bit with the layers property palette, and you can create a set of group filters. There's various reasons you might want to do this. What I'm looking at here is a plant layout drawing. Well, what if I wanted to only see the layers that make up the actual property structure? So I don't want any machines, personnel, product, that kind of thing. So I'm going to make a new layer group filter. I'm going to right click on all, new group filter, give it a name. I'll just say property, keep it kind of generic. So there's nothing in here yet. I'm going to go back to the all filter or the all unused, either one you want to work with. And I'm going to select, I'm going to use the control key and select the different layers that represent the property structure. So that's going to be things like building walls, column pillars, concrete walls, fence lines, and light poles. And I think that's probably, well, we are looking at property, so I'll go ahead and include the navigational star. So with those layers selected, all I need to do is drag and drop to that property layer group. Now, when I go to that layer group, I can right click on it, choose isolate group in all viewports. It's going to give me a warning about any layers that can't be frozen or turned off or anything like that. Go ahead and say okay, close the palette, and that's what you get. Those are the layers from that group. Basically, what it has done is it has gone through and it has frozen all of the other layers in your layer manager. You can get them all back by simply using thaw all layers, and that brings them all back. Your layer group filter is still there if you ever need to use it.